opportunity to present my research. So I'm a three-year PhD student from the Burgundy and Franche-Comté University, and I work at the CICAREX Beaujolais in Villefranche-sur-Saône in collaboration with two labs, the CHGA in Dijon and the ISA in Lille. So today I will present a part of my thesis research which aims to understand how red wines from different vineyards and grape varieties are represented by wine professionals and consumers. So the Beaujolais terroir extends from Mâcon to Lyon, which is composed of a majority of red wines. We have 12 PDO wines made from the same grape variety, the Gamay, with close geographic areas. So for some years now, some red wines are produced also from Gamay wines, but they are not PDOs. So the overall question is to know how the red wines produced in Beaujolais are represented by wine professionals and consumers and compared to those from close vineyards and grape varieties with a different terroir. So when we look at some wine books or wine guides or even wine stores, the wines are overclassified according to their terroir and by either vineyards, but also by grape varieties. Here we have an example of a wine list, and also a website, so you have the grape varieties, and also wine stores with Chardonnay and Merlot and others. So to distinguish wines, the label information is therefore important. So here we have an example of a kind of wine labels for the old world wines, and here a kind of wine labels for the new world wines. So in this kind of French wine label, the first information that appears is information about the denomination. So here you have the PDO Morgon. And for this wine label, we have the information of the brand, the vineyard, the grape variety here, and the denomination with the AVA. For the Swiss wines, this is also this kind of wine label. So we have for this label, an explicit information about terroir information, while for this kind of label, we have to know what a Morgon wine is to know what is the grape variety and the vineyard. Sometimes we have back labels in the bottles, but it's not always written what the vineyard and the grape variety are. So the aim of our study is to understand the information wine professionals and consumers use to categorize a high number of wine labels. So do they use the terroir information to categorize wines? So by vineyards or by grape varieties, or both, or by another kind of information written on labels or not. So to answer this question, we selected three close grape varieties, the Pinot Noir, the Gamay, and the Gamay. And three close vineyards, the Burgundy, the Switzerland, and the Beaujolais. So we selected six wine label categories: Pinot Noir from wines from Burgundy and Switzerland, Gamay wines from Beaujolais and Switzerland, and Gamay wines from Beaujolais and Switzerland. So for each category, wine labels were collected in picture form from an internet research using the category names as keywords in order to represent as much as possible the diversity of wine labels within each category. So here you have an example of the diversity of wine labels for the Gamay wines from the Beaujolais Vineyard. So then we ask, we have collected 287 pictures, and we ask 10 persons internally to sort the wine labels according to visual criteria in order to select different wine labels for each category. And each category was finally represented by 10 labels, except for the Gamay wines from the Beaujolais because of a small production of those wines in the vineyard. So we recruited 3 panels of 5 assessors with different expertise and familiarity with wines, a panel of 40 assessors of experts from the Beaujolais vineyard. They were winemakers, enologists, vineyard wine engineers. A panel of 30 familiar consumers from the Beaujolais vineyard. And a panel of 30 unfamiliar consumers from Lille in the north of France, because there is no vineyard and their culture is not the wine culture but the beer culture because of the proximity with Belgium. So to answer our question, we use the 3 hierarchical sorting task. 3 because we ask each assessor to sort, 3 because they were free to make as many groups as they like, and hierarchical because we ask them to do successive sorting. So for instance, we ask an assessor to sort the wine labels in 2 wine category groups, and for first sorting he could make 6 wine groups. Then we ask him if he could group together some of his groups, and for a second sorting he made 3 groups of wine labels. And then we ask him to if he could separate some of these groups for third sorting. So at any time the assessors could refuse to do the task if they could not. After completing the sorting task, assessors were asked to describe in their own words the groups they had made at the maximum level of separation. So here it's for the third sorting in this particular case. And to finish, each assessor was interviewed in order to access the strategies and criteria used to make those groups. So for the statistical analysis, the sorting data were first analyzed separately for each panel using a hierarchical multiple factor analysis, HMFA, and coupled to a hierarchical ascending classification, HAC, which was performed on the first HMA dimensions, explaining 85% of variance with Ward's criterion. So this analysis permits to obtain 2 maps, a label map, which represents the projections of wine labels on the 2 dimensions of the HMFA, and a subject map, which represents the projections of the assessors on the first 2 dimensions of the HMFA. And for the interview data, we use a correspondence analysis coupled to HAC in order to highlight the main criteria and strategies used to sort the wine labels by each panel. And this analysis permits to obtain this kind of maps for all the panels. So for the expert panel, the graphical projections of the assessors show the division within the expert panel in 2 subgroups, one with 22 experts, 22 experts, and the second one with 8 experts. So this division cannot be explained in terms of gender, age, or profession, so we decided to perform separate HMFA coupled to HSC for each subgroup of subject in order to better understand this division. So here, this is how the results for the first subgroups of experts. This figure shows the projections of wine labels on the first two dimensions of the HMFA, along with the 95% confidence interval around each label, represented here by the orange ellipse. We can see that the labels, which are represented by the black points here, are very close from each other and within the same wine category, with a lot of overlapping. So for better visibility, I have reported the label codes here with a different color for each wine category. And the dotted rectangles represent the cluster, the clusters obtained by the HAC analysis to identify the wine label groups. So finally, we can see wine categorization by both vineyard and grape variety. Donc, here we have the Gamay from Beaujolais, the Pinot Noir from Switzerland, the Pinot Noir from Burgundy, the Gamay from Switzerland, and here all the Gamay from Switzerland and Beaujolais. And the verbalization for each wine group are named either by vineyard, Switzerland, Beaujolais, and Burgundian here, or the names of the appellations, Moulin à Vent, Brouilly, or the names of the grape variety, here Gamay and Gamay here. For the second subgroup of experts, the categorization of the wine labels is based on multi-criteria. That's why there is a lot of variability between experts. So the criteria used were mostly colors and visual criteria for a marketing purpose. For the familiar consumers, the categorization was the same as the first group of experts. We can see wine categorization by both vineyard and grape variety. Here we have the Gamay from Beaujolais, Pinot Noir from Burgundy, Pinot Noir from Switzerland, Gamay from Switzerland, and again all the Gamay from Switzerland and Beaujolais. For the unfamiliar consumers, we can also see a wine categorization by grape varieties and vineyards, and the groups obtained are named either by grape varieties, vineyards, or appellations. So here we have Pinot Noir, Burgundy, Gevrey Chambertin, Beaujolais, Beaujolais Nouveau, Gamay, Switzerland, and so on. So for the interview's results, here is a map of the projections of the main criteria in blue here, and strategies in green used by the panels. So the dotted ellipses represent the clusters obtained by HAC, which were coupled to an hypergeometric law in order to highlight the main criteria and strategies used to sort the wine labels by each panel. So we can see here for the first groups of experts and the familiar consumers that they use the same criteria and strategies to sort the wine labels. So we have appellation, variety criteria, and knowledge strategies. So they use mainly their knowledge on vineyards and grape varieties. For the unfamiliar consumers, they simply read the labels to find clues and deduce wine groups. And for the second group of experts, they chose to follow another purpose to categorize the wine labels. So to conclude, the results indicate that an interaction between the grape variety and the vineyard dimensions for the wine categorization by experts and consumers. Vineyard and grape variety designations have therefore the same weight in categories in categorizing the wine labels. Because of a lack of knowledge, the unfamiliar consumers simply read the labels to find clues and deduce the wine groups, categorizing the labels by vineyards and grape varieties with some errors. So the terroir information or label seems to be sufficient to deduce the same wine categories than experts and familiar consumers. But when we read more precisely each transcription of the interviews, we can see that it is simply an appearance. Even if they are good readers, the unfamiliar consumers do not understand very well the wine classification by vineyards or by grape varieties. For instance, they look at the postcode, or then for the Côte du Rhône wines, I have separated the Beaujolais, the Beaujolais Village, and the Beaujolais Nouveau, and also the Gamaret for the Côte du Rhône. So, because he saw the postcode, he made a wrong deduction. Or then some of them said, I have tried all the same names together, not by region, just by name, or first mostly by grape variety, I think, the appellation of the grape variety. So even they are sensitive to the grape variety, they do not always know what the grape variety really means. So I will thank you for your attention.